Welcome back to Mood India, California Arts Association's presentation of performing arts from India. I'm your host, Arvind Kansal. Continuing our series on Indian classical music, today we're going to talk about a rag Hansdhwani. We have Nachiket Sharma who's going to talk and give us bandishes in several formats. Nachiket has been both a performing artist, a teacher living in the San Francisco Bay Area. His guru is Pandit Basavraj Rajguru. He's going to be accompanied on harmonium by Vivek Dadar. Our viewers would recognize Vivek readily. He is a student of Pandit Vinayak Rao Kale. Accompanying them both is Abhinay Padhe, another regular of our program. He has learned from Sri Nanamuli, Pandit Bhai Kaitonde from India. He continues to learn from Pandit Swapan Chaudhary. In his free time, he is both a copious performer as well as a teacher. Welcome. So, Rag Hansdhwani is a very interesting rag, and from what I understand, it means the song of a swan.
That's correct. Hansdhwani is indeed a very interesting rag. It is a very lively, dynamic, in other words, a beautiful rag. It is. it has a pentatonic structure, or what we call the ordhav jati, mm-hmm. which is five notes going up, five notes coming down. It goes something like this. You notice that the rishab, is a nice resting point mm-hmm. in the rag. The vadi of this rag, or the most important note, is pa, and the samadhi is sa, but still the resting point is re.
Right.
Pa ga re, sa re ga.
Now, apparently this is a fairly recent rag in Hindustani classical.
That's correct. It is this rag is an import from the Carnatic tradition,
yeah.
And the Hindustani version, the Hindustani age of this rag is fairly recent as in maybe just over 100 to 150 years old. The name is also Carnatic. It has not changed in its in the process of transition. Yeah. It is it's a beautiful rag. It is it evokes all kinds of emotion, especially those of joy mm-hmm. And exuberance. It's that kind of rag. And bandishes or compositions in this rag typically tend to be very, very vivacious.
Mm. So perhaps you could show our viewers something?
Certainly. The first, I'll be singing two bandishes or two compositions. The first one is in Tal Rupak, or seven beats. It's for a slightly slower pace than the second one, or the next one that I'm going to be singing, which is in Tal Teen Tal, or consisting of 16 beats.
Mm-hmm. So that'll be set up a nice contrast.
Yes.
Ah, 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 ah
So earlier on you mentioned that Raghastvani has Carnatic origins. So tell us something more about it.
You notice that the two of the three bandishes that I sang, they went like this. The first one was Shri Shankara Sota Ganesh. The third one was Lagi Lagana Sakhe Pati. Both these bandishes are modeled after the very famous Carnatic composition by the great Muthuswami Dikshita, which is Vatapi Ganapatim Bhajayam, and it goes like this. It is just the same tune. Vatapi Ganapatim Bhajayam, Vatapi Ganapatim Bhajayam. So you'll notice that these two bandishes, they are modeled after that the Carnatic composition. In fact, there are a few other songs also that have follow that same model. One is a very famous tarana by Ustad Amir Khan. Tanom tadari tadim tadari tani tanom tadari tadim tadari tani tanom tadari tadim tadari. Same. And then there is a film song composed by Salil Chaudhary in the movie, I believe it was Parivar, and sung by Lata Mangeshkar, and it jaato se nahi bolu kanhaiya raah chalat pakdi mori baiya raah chalat pakdi mori baiya jaato se nahi jaato se nahi ja. She has used a little bit of a dha there, which is absent from Hamsadhwani, but because it's a filmy song, I guess we can make these
some liberties.
So the ma and the dha are missing from, are conspicuously absent from Hamsadhwani. It does not contain ma and dha. The resting place of the rishab or the re is I would say quite unique to Hindustani. In the sense, there are certain phrases that you do not take in Hindustani that you can in Carnatic. For example, sa re ga ga re ne pa sa ne re sa re ga. In the Carnatic tradition, there isn't necessarily a restriction. For example, of singing ne re ga. In our tradition, it became the Hindustani. In Hindustani tradition, and the Nirega goes into the Kalyan Thaat. I had not mentioned this earlier, but Hamsadhwani belongs to the Bilawal Thaat, and hence the tendency to stick to Sarega. Nirega automatically puts it in the Kalyan category. So the Sarega and bringing it back to the resting place of Rishab or the Re makes it very uniquely Hindustani flavor.
That's a very interesting point. And this is, as I understand, an evening, early night
rag. It's an evening, early night rag. Mm-hmm. And because it is so popular, people tend to sing it for different genres. I mean, they use Hamsa Dhwani for bhajans and devotional songs and filmy songs, obviously. Mm-hmm. And so it becomes more... you have more liberty to sing it at pretty much any time of the day.
It's more widely adapted
to
that.
But traditionally it is it's an evening night rag.
Okay. So which is the next bandish that you're going to...
Yeah, this next bandish is a fantastic composition by, once again, Pandit Ramashraya Jha, who goes by the pen name Ram Rang. Mm-hmm. And here again is an invocation to Lord Ganesh. He says, Jai Jai Ganapati Deva in this. And it's set to Teen Taal once again. Okay. Jaya, jaya.
concludes our today's conversation with Nachiket Sharma. Thank you for joining us. Mood India's programs are a presentation by California Arts Association. We welcome your feedback and suggestions and hope to see you again next time. Until then, namaste. Jaya, 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 jaya.